please subscribe to my channel and press bell icon so you will never miss any update for upcoming videos. And don't forget to like.
It is now time for the auspicious lighting the lamp ceremony to symbolically spread the brightness of wisdom and knowledge. So now I'd like to request our respected chief guest, Shri Pawan, Agrawal sir, to inaugurate this 8th International Food Convention by lighting the traditional lamp as per Indian customs and tradition. And I also request other dignitaries to join our chief guest in lighting the traditional lamp.
Call as Mahakumbh Though Dr. Prabhos mentioned that this is too good, but now it is turning out to be a mahakumbh for food and technology professionals of the country. I think the step up in terms of participation of delegates and the variety of activities that we are going to have over the next 3 days deserves upgradation from kumbh to mahakumbh. I would particularly like to congratulate AFSTI India team for the wonderful job they have been doing over the last 2-3 years, particularly, you know, that is my personal experience of working with this association. As you have heard about my background in terms of experience and education, I do not claim to have any experience or competence in the area of food safety or nutrition prior to joining this assignment. And most of my education in this space has happened only through many of you who are present here today. I would particularly like to mention, you know, Dr. Prabodh Halde, your current president, and many of his colleagues in the AFSTI, with whom I had the privilege of working during these last 3 years as we move forward in transforming the food safety and nutrition landscape in the country. I had occasion to visit two of the most prestigious institutions for food in the country this morning, and I was amazed, and I think it is extremely happy to see the variety of things the CFTRI and the DFRL has been doing for the nation for many decades. I would, however, regret that I was delayed in visiting Mysore and to have come earlier. I can assure you, the two directors of the DFRL and CFTRI who are sitting on the dais here today, I can assure you that moving forward, we will work more closely with the two institutions as we have been working with our neighboring university, NIFTEM, you know, and I acknowledge the presence of Professor Vasudeva, with whom we work very closely in Delhi. As Dr. Prabodh Halde mentioned, you know, I had privilege of attending your national convention at Hyderabad last year, wherein I gave AFSTI 5 tasks. In fact, 4 were defined and 5th we said you choose your own task. And I got a report on what has happened on that, and I'll just read out to you what has been the report of the 5 tasks. First was, you know, support on Project Goal. Project Goal was to ensure safe food or safe prasadam in temples and places of worship in the country. Even though, you know, AFSTI often gives credit for that initiative to FSSAI, but truly speaking, it was Mumbai chapter of AFSTI which initiated this program, and then Tamil Nadu chapter and other chapters across the country took it forward. Now it has become despite the complicated nature of ensuring food safety and hygiene in places of worship, something that I think has given FSSAI a lot of visibility. 1, 2, address a very important safety and hygiene issue, which is the food that one gets in this university. I must place a record, my deep appreciation for the work that AFSTI has done in this regard. So, 100 marks to them for this initiative. Second, first step. Friends, over the last few years, we have created a new vocabulary for food, food safety and nutrition. And in this vocabulary, many of you will be aware, FOSTEC is a new word that we have added to our dictionary. FOSTEC is food safety, training and certification. Food safety, training and certification. FOSTEC. This is essentially to build a culture of self-compliance in food businesses by structured training and building the competences of the food handlers and supervisors who work in different food businesses. Friends, I am very happy to share with you that we today have 150 training partners who are implementing these programs across the country, and about 65,000 food safety supervisors have been trained. Much of the hard work in terms of setting curriculum, in terms of trainers for in these training programs, and in fact responsibility in many cases of organizing these training programs have been taken by different chapters of AFSTI. Again, we can give 100 marks to AFSTI for these initiatives. As we move forward to create a culture of self-compliance around food safety in the country, I think we have a long journey ahead. We have 2.8 million food businesses. So 63,000 is a good beginning, but a long way to go. And therefore, we do hope that all of you can continue to support it and support it with more vigor. Next is AFSTI, FSSAI Food Safety Awards. These awards have been instituted, and I am pleased to announce that the awardees will be declared in today's event. And I would like to convey my congratulations to the awardees in advance on this occasion. So we can again give 100% marks to AFSTI for this. Fourth initiative was around creating a pool of research scientists and technologists for various activities of FSSAI, and in particular to help us not only in creating curriculum for FOSTEC but also to develop food safety management system manuals. The manuals that can become the guided documents for food businesses as they ensure food safety across the value chain. Happy to share with you that in almost all areas across different verticals, meat, cereals, bakery, these documents are almost ready, and would like to place again on record that appreciation for AFSTI members who have contributed immensely to this task. Again, 100% marks. to AFSTI. Finally, you know, many of you friends will be aware that we have recently, in our effort to ensure that our citizens eat right, eat safe, eat healthy, and also eat fortified to address micronutrient deficiencies, we launched an Eat Right India movement, a citizens movement, where we expect to reach all our citizens through a campaign mode. One part of this campaign was the Swasth Bharat Yatra. The Swasth Bharat Yatra was flagged off from Leh, Panjim, Trivandrum, Puducherry, Agartala, and Ranchi on the World Food Day, the 16th October this year. To cycle through 25 cyclists and have activities at different locations as they move forward and come home to Delhi over more than 100 days. I'm happy to share that in first 50 days of this yatra, already 10,000 kilometers has been traveled. About 225,000 people have either cycled or participated in rallies and programs associated with Swasth Bharat Yatra. It is becoming truly a mass movement. And it was envisaged to be a mass movement because it was inspired by no other than Mahatma Gandhi or Bapu, an occasion of 150th year of his birth. As we move forward, the Eat Right India movement will define the way the country eats and will in turn, through a demand-side push, ensure that the food available in the market, it is safe and it is healthy. The other elements of the Eat Right India movement, they are still, you know, why the Swasth Bharat Yatra is now moving towards Delhi and another 50 days to go. So I would ask all of you, as you have participated in some of the states where it had gone, a similar participation would ensure the success of this yatra as it meets all these tracks meet on the Republic Day, 26th of January 2019 in Delhi. I will place on the call that some of the AFSTI members not only participated proactively but even cycled, and one of them was no one other than your own president, AFSTI, Dr. Prabhu Balde, who cycled for 40 kilometers. And of course, you know, one of my colleagues is Dr. Bhaskar, who is a faculty in CFTRI, now scientific advisor in FSSAI, he also cycled. So let us give a big round of applause. Since the cycling relay or cyclothon is midway, I will not give 100 marks. I will give 50 marks. So out of 500, AFSTI gets 450 marks. So 50 marks are not lost. 50 marks will be given, maybe more will be given, as the cyclothon or this relay converges to New Delhi, wherein we recognize and reward individuals, associations, food businesses, and everyone else who have contributed to the success of this yatra and this mass mobilization movement as we are undertaking. We have also instituted EatRight Awards, EatRight Startup Awards, EatRight Creativity Challenge, and finally, something like this in Delhi, we are calling it EatRight Mela, wherein we expect to get about 100,000 people over the coming weekend in Delhi around EatRight. So, I think as FSSAI is transforming the country's food safety and nutrition landscape and working with consumers directly as one of the strategies to improve our food system, we work with various partners, and as food scientists and technologists, we see you as very valued partner, and AFSTI as extremely valuable association to work with. I do hope that this partnership between AFSTI and FSSAI will ensure that we are able to provide safe and wholesome food to our citizens. Thank you. Jai Hind.